Welcome to Alena Helena TV. And my name is Janet Agbalanyo. It's time for our African history. But before then, let's go for a break. When I come back, it still continues. Welcome back from that break, and today we are going to look at Tanzania. So, Tanzania is located at the east of the equator, and Tanzania was formed as a sovereign state in 1964 through the union of the inter-four separate states of the Tanzayaki and the Zanzibar. The mainland Tanzayaki covers more than 90% of the combined territory's total area. Mafia Island is administrated from the mainland, while Zanzibar and the Pamba Island have a separate government administration. Dodoma, since 1974, the designated official capital of Tanzania, is centrally located on the mainland. The Dar es Salaam, however, remains the seat of most government administration, as well as being in the largest city and the port in the country. The Tanzania mainland is bounded by Uganda, Lake Equatorial, and Kenya to the north, by the Indian Ocean to the east, by Mozambique and Lake Nyasa, Malawi, and Zambia to the south and southwest, and by Lake Tanganyika, Burundi, and Rwanda to the west, except for the narrow coastal belts of the mainland and the offshore island. Most of the mainland Tanzania lies above 600 feet to, or 600 feet, you can just equate it to 200 meters in elevation. Vast stretches of plains and plateau contrast with spectacular relief features, notably Africa's highest mountains, Kilimanjaro, that is could be measured in the 19,340 feet, and the world's second deepest lake, Lake Tanganyika. Anyway, it's an interesting name. That is also measured in 4,710 feet deep. The East African Rift System runs in two north-south trending branches through the mainland Tanzania, leaving many narrow, deep depressions that are often filled by lakes. One's Bounce and Western Rift Valley runs along the western frontier, and it's marked by lakes Tanganyika and the Ruka, while the other branches, the Eastern or Great Rift Valley, extends through central Tanzania from the Kenyan border in the region of Lake Isai, Iasi and Mayara, and Natru south to the east Nyasa of the border of Mozambique. The central plateau, covering more than a third of the country, lies between the two branches. Highlands associated with the Western Rift Valley are formed by the Urefa Plateau and the Ambia Range and Runway Mountains in the southwestern corner of the country. From there, the South Highland run northwest along the Great Rift in the Akuraju and the Nura Mountains northwest of Morogoro, extending from the northern coast, and the Usambara and the Bari Mountains chains run in the southern to the northeast direction, calculating the Kilimanjaro roughly snow clip peak and containing beyond to the Mount Mari, that is also measured in the 14,000 that is also measured in 14,978 feet, immediately to the west of Mount Meru. Another chain of mountains began, which include the still active volcano Ol Doiano Lamink and the Narogoro Center, and the world's largest caldera and or volcano depression. This chain extends through a corridor of between Lake Nyasa and Lake Mayara towards Dodoma. Because of its numerous lakes, approximately 22,800 square miles, that could also be measured in kilometers, 59,000 square in kilometers, as we all know, of Tanzania's territory, consisting of the inland water. Lake Victoria, which runs as the world's second largest freshwater lake, is not part of the rift system. Although Tanzania has no big rivers, it forms the divided from which the three great rivers of the African countries rises, the Nile, the Congo, and the Zimbabwe, which flows off the Mediterranean Sea, the Atlantic Ocean, and the Indian Ocean, respectively. Separated from the central plateau, the watersheds of this river do not meet. All of Tanzania's major rivers, the Ruvuma and the Rufiji and the Wumi and the Pangani, drains into the Indian Ocean, and the largest, the Rufiji River, has a drainage system that extends over most of South mainland Tanzania. The Kanjari River flows into Lake Victoria, where other minor rivers flow into the internal basins formed by the Great Rift Valley. With so many rivers, mainland Tanzania is rich in hydroelectricity potential. Mainland Tanzania can be divided into four principal climate and topographic areas: the hot and the humid coastal lowlands of the Indian Ocean shorelines, the hot and the arid zone of the broad central plateau, the high inland mountains, and the lake region of the northern border, where Mount Kilimanjaro is situated, and the highland of the northeast and the southeast, the climate of which range from tropical to temperate and to temperature. Tanzania's warm equatorial climate is modified by the variation of elevation. The high amount of solar radiation throughout the years is associated with the limited seasonal fluctuations of temperature. Rainfall is highly seasonal, being influenced greatly by the annual migration of the intertropical reference zone. Roughly half of the mainland Tanzania received less than 30 inches, you can also measure that in millimeter, of a precise annually, an amount considered in the minimum required for most forms of crop cultivation in the tropics. The central plateau, which receives less than 20 inches per year in average, is the drainest area and experiences a single rainy season between December and May. Precipitation is heavier on the coast, where there are two peaks of precipitation, October to November and April to May. The offshore island and many highland areas have high annual precipitation totals of more than 60 inches. That is a little history about Tanzania. So if you want a place to just go relax, just go to Tanzania. They have lots of interesting history for you to explore. This is News African History, and my name is Janet Agbalanyu. Thanks for watching, and do send us your comments on our social media handles. We will read them for you. Thanks for watching. See you next time.